is America, Lois. Men have always run things, and there have never been any problems whatsoever. And don't say the economy or Iraq or income inequality or racism or Brett Kavanaugh or air pollution or Vietnam or slavery or Watergate or capitalism or Me Too or homelessness or police brutality or homophobia or Monica Lewinsky or school shootings or Native American genocide or Fox News or Tim Allen or climate change.
This is an impression of my dad explaining his and my mom's divorce, but my dad is Eminem.
The 2008 financial recession has put a tremendous toll on me and your mother's marriage. And so when asked if we wanted to renew our vows, we both said nay. Like a two-horse-drawn carriage, parents, union, cut short like Karen's been errand, running back and forth from courts like sports. In fact, that's an active, apt metaphor for our course of action. See, me and your mom faced off in court and had a bad time. Nothing made sense. So after two quarters, we decided on halftime, but something's not quite right. See, something's been brain busting me. These alimony fiends, they trying to get a huff of me. I give your mom the green, but we still split joint custody. Ugh. Very sorry, though.
Motherfucker.
Short skirts, I wear t-shirts. It's weird that Taylor Swift thinks that you can't wear both of those items of clothing at the same time. Is the girl in this song who wears the short skirts not wearing a shirt? Maybe that's part of the reason why the guy likes her so much.
We're such a mess together. You make me lose my temper. You're the only one.
So for starters, everyone is different. We're painting with broad brush here, blah blah blah, whatever. If you take a bunch of girls and raise them as boys, then it turns out that they're going to respond to that in a lot of different ways. The stereotypical one is for them to, even from an early age, be inexorably drawn to overtly feminine things like heels and dresses and lipstick. But guess what? Gender exploration is heavily discouraged, especially in boys. So a lot of us, most of us really, learn not to do that. Some of these girls will react by leaning very hard into masculinity, being a jock, growing a beard, joining the military. Another viable route is to slot yourself into a plausible archetype of masculinity that people won't question but doesn't really require a lot of traditionally overtly masculine virtues. For instance, the squirrely computer geek or gamer nerd, who is generally expected to use brain rather than brawn. As an added benefit, video games are great for living in your head and not physically existing in your body. As for why they're sad, well...
already know who it is. It's your boy.
Randall, there is a cow outside.
There's a cow farm. You're gonna find cows outside.
Remember that whole joke about how we're all going to have to wear t-shirts that say we are something else? So in this case, I would be Cornell when it comes to facial recognition systems trying to identify us off the street. Turns out you might actually be able to do that. Basically, there's this model called Clip. It was developed by a company named OpenAI, and it's designed to tell us what is in images. So on the top, you have a picture of a television studio. It sees that there is a television studio in there, so it labels it as being most likely being a television studio. Same with the airplane on the next photo. The problem is that Clip was trained as a model that associates text, like actual words, with images, which means that if you put a word over an image, say a Granny Smith apple, which you can see on top, it will actually think it is that thing. So now we have an iPod in this photo, no longer an apple. This is called an adversarial attack, and if you want to learn more how this works, you can follow me on TikTok to find more videos.
Can I get that strong? Can I get that rummy? Can I get that coke? Can I get that henny? Can I get that margarita on the rock, rock, rocks? Can I get salt all around that rum, 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 rum tray? I was like, yo, Trey, do you think you could buy me a bottle of rosé? Okay, let's go.
I hope you're ready. With our combined feminine prowess, they'll be toast in no time flat.
Well, yeah, I suppose I wouldn't mind knocking Ash down a peg or two.
Let's blow those whining women back to the dark ages right where they belong.
Let me show you how I made this ball pit ball chain. If you're looking to spice up your wardrobe, this is totally the way to go. Here's what you'll need. Ball pit balls, avi, a thick pointed needle, a spool of cloth-covered elastic cord, a good handful of lobster clips, and a pair of pliers. Tie your elastic cord onto your needle, and you're gonna force that bad boy right through your ball pit ball. If the ball deflates or becomes a little warped, that's okay, the plastic is thin and easy to reform. String on as little or as many balls as you'd like, take your lobster clips, and then slide them right onto the end. You're just gonna tie it, it's super simple and easy. This activity is so easy to do once you have the materials you need. I've made 10 already, and I still have a ton of ball pit balls left over. If you're a seasoned candy kid, I think this activity is kind of a must.
Guess you got mail! I actually have no idea what this is. I guess I'll open it.
So, like, my dead name is, like, really, really uncommon, which is definitely a privilege because I, like, never hear it anywhere, which is super nice. But the one, like, thing that is kind of annoying is, like, sometimes people will ask me how to pronounce it. Like, they'll see it and they'll ask me how to pronounce it. Like, one time I was getting my name on my apartment's lease and the lady was like, "That's an interesting name. How do you say that?" And I'm like, "Oh, I don't really care." Like, I'm like, trying to play it off. I'm like, "I don't really care. Like, it's okay. It doesn't bother me. Like, anyway, it's fine." When really, like, it does bother me to hear that name at all, no matter how it's pronounced. And she's just like, "Can you tell me how to say your name?" And I'm sort of like, "Well, I would really prefer you say it, Hugo." I know, weird spelling, but it's Hugo.
If you have an idea that you genuinely think is good, don't let some idiot talk you out of it. Now, that doesn't mean that every wild notion you come up with is going to be genius, but if there is something that you feel is good, something you want to do, something that means something to you, try to do it. Because I think you can only do your best work if you're doing what you want to do, and if you're doing it the way you think it should be done, and if you can take pride in it after you've done it, no matter what it is, you can look at it and say, "I did that, and I think it's pretty damn good." That's a great feeling. So don't let idiots talk you out of something that you think is good.
Leave Pisces men alone. Leave all Pisces alone. I don't know what's going on. I do know what's going on. I'm not a Pisces, okay? I'm a Cancer. I just have a lot of feelings. Currently squashing our tofu.
Okay, I'm not naming any names, but hypothetically, I was an immortal creature that survived off of, you know, human blood. The first thing that I would do is start a myth that an object or an item, a consumable item, let's say, that increases human blood flow and essentially turns them into a human Capri Sun is actually my mortal weakness.
Howdy, gang. I'm gonna make this quick because 60 seconds is not a lot of time. Basically, I have been collecting data from the men that like me on Hinge, all from age ranges 19 to 39. Now, I just wanted to come here and tell you some very fun and interesting facts I found out. So the first thing I did with all of these men is I matched with every single man that liked me. And then I sent them the message, "What are your top three favorite movies?" Now, I've got them all written down, but that will come into play later. Basically, the first part of information that I really wanted to share was, out of the men that I asked, "What are your favorite movies?" because some people did just never respond. 100% of the men who did not answer the question, changed the subject, answered incorrectly on purpose, or made me ask a second time, 100% sent a sexually inappropriate message later on, or just like incredibly demanding and told me what to do. Why do I think this is? These men are clearly inconsiderate and they are not considering how they're making other people feel, how to have polite conversation, understanding social boundaries. Which obviously makes sense, but 100% is ridiculous. It's really no fuss, as long as you're next to me,
just the two of us. Okay, so let's answer some questions. Okay, so
The first one I've been seeing a lot, it... So, firstly, do I have the power of God in anime still? Yes, everyone does. You get the power of God in anime when you're nice to people and you aren't a dick. So if you're not a dick to people, you have the power of God in anime. Already, fun fact. Another one, dude in the video said I was 15. I'm 19 on Friday, so tomorrow. So I'm not actually 15. I saw a lot of confusion about the timeline. I can explain the timeline, but it came out in middle school. It was recorded in middle school and it got posted my freshman year of high school summer, like leading into it. So, yeah, let's see. I've also been seeing a lot of stuff about reshooting the video or remaking it. And honestly, probably my thoughts on that.
One of the many great things I love from TMA is that there's so many genders, including, probably not, plastic, maybe, no, last but certainly not the least of the genders, is goth.
Shocker! When I was a little baby, my parents named me Sasha. S-A-S-H-A. S-A-S-H-A. But since I'm trans, people- Why did I say it like that? Trans! Since I'm trans, people are always like, why didn't you change your name when you transitioned? I mean, you go by a woman's name, you go by a female name, you go by a girl's name. I mean, what in God's name are you thinking? And some of you guys might be thinking, Sasha probably goes by Sasha because Sasha is a unisex name, and although it's way more common for girls in the US, on the other hand, in Russia where it originated, it's a boy's name and it translates to Alexander. No, you're all wrong.
I live how I live and I do what I do, and I do it all for English actor, writer, and producer Sasha Baron Cohen.
That dude's name is Sasha. Probably gets bullied severely. I mean, I'm transgender. What is his excuse? I kept my name to show solidarity.
I kept my name because Mr. Cohen, he needs our support.
You know what's something you can do in a book that you can't do in a movie? One of my favorite things is when a book will be told from multiple different perspectives, and it'll introduce a character in one perspective that has already been introduced in another perspective. But because they're being described from a different person's point of view, it takes the audience a couple of chapters to figure out that the two characters that are being described are the same person. Like, you can't do that in a movie, because, you know, it's just the same actor. People will be like, yeah, that's Brad Pitt again, same guy. One of the downsides of books is it's harder to have insignificant background details that become important later. Like in a movie, you can just like place a prop in the background and the audience might notice, might not, but then it becomes important and they're like, ooh. But if you're writing a book, you have to actually describe the prop, which will call attention to it, and the audience will be like, okay, that's gonna be important later. Like, one of the big benefits of books is the audience only sees what you let them see, so you have a lot more control from a narrative perspective. The trade-off being that every detail you provide feels very deliberate.
Breaky! Watch for me on the news. Mama's getting the free helicopter ride. It turns out rescue helicopter rides are not free, and through a complete accident that nobody could have seen coming, my ice shelf broke off and I'm now stranded in the middle of Lake Huron.
I don't dress like a gender-bending, colorful freak for you. I don't dress like a gender-bending, colorful freak for me. I dress like a gender-bending, colorful freak so that when I walk past young children in public, they smile at me and ask what gender I am.
I think it's really sexy of me to have different pronouns on my main and on my spam, because it's like, oh, these are my secret pronouns. Like, everyone gets the one pronoun, but if you go into the woods and accept a quest from a little pixie that leads you to, like, a tree stump that has the other pronoun set carved in them, now you get to use those ones. Y'all have found the latest clues in the ARG of decoding my gender. Best of luck, no one's done it. I haven't done it.
Have always been thought of to be painted by male hunters. Actually, they were done by females.
But did you know that some cave art is actually done by children? How they were able to figure this out was via through the flutings, which is basically just taking your fingers, three fingers, and stroking them through soft clay, like here, where you see these. And they were able to determine that the ages of the children were between the ages of 2 to 3 to about 7 years old. And some of these finger flutings were found on the ceiling, which means that the adults were actively a part of this, where they were picking up the children and holding them up to the ceiling so that they could do their artwork. Even some of them where you can see the lines are much steadier, which means that the adults were holding the hand of the children and helping them and guiding them, which means they were actively encouraging it. There was even one room where there were just thousands of finger flutings. You can even see the kids line over the adult. I mean, this is amazing because it means that art has been as much of our culture and a part of us as hunting and gathering has been.
haven't been in my suite much. I feel I don't know how to relate to these straight men, but they seem like really sweet guys. I popped in for about 5 minutes yesterday to use the bathroom, and then I was gonna take off again. I'm coming out of the bathroom, and one of them comes up to me, and he points at the floor, and he says, "The bathroom puddle's back." I said, "Yeah! The bathroom puddle's always there. The floor tilts. The water gathers. There's always gonna be a bathroom puddle." But we talked about it. We bonded over it. I love that man. Ben.
What are your thoughts on the Jesse Waters video on Fox News?
The chicken reporter who came down here and thought he was big because he talked to people who couldn't speak English.
Yeah, that douchebag, he's a
The one who was sent here by the larger chicken who couldn't come to Chinatown because he was afraid to do it himself. You did that one?
Yeah, that guy.
The one with no testicles. The one who came down here who said, let me talk to some old people and let me put them on camera without asking them and sort of put them on national television and made fun of them in the worst possible way. That asshole.
Okay, I think we're talking about the same guy.
Right. What was the question again?
I can't remember.
Do you like how I walk? Do you like how I talk?
Do you like how my face disintegrates?
I have a wonderful wife, I have a powerful job. She criticizes me for being egocentric. You practice your mannerisms into the wall. If this mirror were clear, I'd be standing so tall.
So you stop her over clovers on the side of the hill.
I was observing the flesh. You know you're making me cry, this is the way that I am. I've been living a lie, a metamorphical scheme.
Detective undercover, brotherhood, objective of sin.
Oh no, no, oh.